The most memorable meal I've ever had at home is the first time that we had steak. I mean, I felt like a grown-up. They gave me my own knife, one big piece of meat. I got to cut my own meat. And it was also the first time I ate carrots, and I loved them. I love that moment so much that I want to immortalize it, recreate it to the best of my memory, and I'm gonna call it my first steak dinner. What I have here is some local ribeye steaks. You know, growing up, we didn't really get a chance to buy those fancy Wagyus or, you know, USDA primes. So we made do with local beef, and you know what? It's pretty good. So for the marinade, I'm gonna start with some Worcestershire sauce. You know, about 1/4 cup to 1/3 cup. And then we're gonna add in some thyme. I like steaks with Worcestershire sauce, a little bit of thyme, a little bit of rosemary. I think that the flavors go really well together, a little bit of the fermented taste. And then some rosemary. This is what a rosemary stock looks like. And just put them in. What you don't want to put in, however, is this really woody stem. So just make sure you don't put that in the blender. I'm also going to add in a little bit of garlic. So about 2 cloves. And then just a touch of olive oil. This will also make sure that our steaks don't stick to the pan. And now we're going to give this a buzz. Okay, that's a really quick marinade right there. And all you have to do is to pour this straight onto our steaks. And we're gonna let that stand for a few minutes. Actually, it can go for almost an hour. Okay, now meanwhile, I'm gonna take care of the side dish. Now, frankly speaking, I look forward to the side dish just as much as the steaks. So I'm gonna turn up the heat, and in my saucepan, I'm gonna add in some butter. So let's add in 2 tablespoons of butter. Okay, let's just pretend that it's 2 tablespoons. I mean, it's just you and me, right? Okay, let's put the butter in. And you just want the butter to melt. You don't really want it to start burning. Okay, what we want to do now is slightly cook the carrots. So you add in carrot batonettes. You can cut the carrots any way you like, but we used to cut them this way. So I'm gonna put them into our pan. And I want the butter and the carrots to come together and heat up at the same time. You can hear that slight sizzle. That's what we want. When you're cooking with just plain butter, you don't want something that's super hot because butter tends to burn fast. So let's mix this around. Okay, I'm gonna season now the carrots. Just some salt and pepper. You know, when I was young, they wouldn't really let me touch the stove. But the one thing that they let me do is season the carrots. So that was my first job in the kitchen. Okay, just a bit of salt. Okay, excellent. Okay, so we're halfway through our cooking process, and now I'm gonna add in my secret ingredient. Well, it's not so secret, really. It's brown sugar. And I love adding brown sugar to carrots because it actually enhances the sweetness of the carrots. So I know it sounds weird that you're adding sugar to a savory dish, but really, it's gonna make your carrots taste so much better. And then we're gonna cook that. And once you get that really nice golden color, you're done. Okay, the carrots are nice and sweet. What I'm gonna do is shut off the heat and then let the residual heat just finish cooking the carrots. I don't want the carrots to be super soft. I want them to be a little crunchy, and that way you get a really nice texture that goes with the steak. So, speaking of the steaks, let's start to cook them. But first, you need a really hot pan. I want to cook the steaks in butter, but I want to use high heat. So what I'm going to do is add in some olive oil. And the olive oil will basically protect your butter from burning. So we want to make sure that our oil is smoking hot. Meanwhile, let's take a look at the steaks. They've been marinating for a short time only, so there's not too much discoloration. Okay, so let's mix this up. Let's just make sure that all parts of the beef are marinated well. Okay, I might be wearing a little bit of the marinade on myself. But that's good, it's all good. Okay, since we marinated this with some Worcestershire sauce, it's probably gonna be salty enough. So what I wanna do is just add a touch of salt, and then just a touch of pepper as well. There you go. So you want some really hot oil, and to make sure you get that, just tilt your pan a little bit. You'll see a little bit of the waves form. And once those waves form, you know your oil is hot enough. Okay, so I've got 5 steaks here, which is good enough for 5 people. Or, you know, me. But then, Once you put in the steaks, that hot oil, that temperature is gonna drop really fast. So that means you can add in your butter now and it's not gonna burn. So a nice chunk of butter all around the pan. So we're also gonna drop in some rosemary whole. And what's gonna happen is they're gonna cook in the oil and the butter. And then your oil and butter will actually start to smell like rosemary. That's the beauty of it. Now, here's the thing. When we were cooking at home, we didn't really have an oven because, you know, some kid just broke the oven. Could have been me, I'm not gonna confirm. But anyway, we didn't have an oven to cook our steaks in, so we were forced to cook over the stovetop. Now, our home cook, bless her heart, you know, she tried her best, but she kept puncturing the steaks, right? And it got really dry. So what we're gonna do instead is baste them in our butter and olive oil. And that's gonna make sure that our steaks are really moist and juicy. And look at that color. Come on, look at that. Beautiful. You get nice char marks, and yet we're indoors, and you don't have a fancy oven or broiler. No, no, we're doing it on the stovetop. Oh, I'm excited to eat this. I'm sure you can tell. Okay, so we wanna cook the steaks to medium, and this is pretty much almost there. So what I want to do now is just do one more basting. There you go, nice. And then we're going to check for doneness, okay? So use your fingers, press, and you'll find out, okay? Right now, it's approaching medium. So what I want to do is shut off the heat, take it away from the heat, and let the residual heat just finish cooking the steak. There's the final touch. That steak plate looks really awesome. I've got a couple of pieces here for me that I'm gonna taste, and I cannot wait. Ooh, I'm gonna have a little bit of the carrots as well. All right, let's taste. I think I got pretty close. You know, the marinade, you can taste hints of the marinade on the beef, but it doesn't overpower the beef, so you can still taste the nice beefy flavor. And then it's really moist and juicy because we took the time to really baste it in butter and oil. And then those carrots, really sweet, brings a nice counterbalance to the steak. You know, this steak takes me back when I was young. You know, it was an innocent time where I was just playing video games and blowing up ovens. Yes, 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 so it was me. I blew up the family oven, okay? But look what happened. We learned to cook over the stove. And here's the silver lining, because this steak is delicious.